Good morning, this is Duane, and we're doing a series of videos called How to Color on the Piano Without Crayons, Creative Ways to Make Your Piano Playing Sound More Interesting. We're going to begin a series today on the tune Ain't She Sweet. We're going to take it from several aspects, and we're going to color it as much as we can in one particular style, roughly known as ragtime or swing bass style. But today, the first day of Ain't She Sweet, I'd like to talk about musical form, because every piece of music has a musical form of some sort. Just like your house has a form. Whoever laid out the plans for your house, they planned a bedroom here and a bedroom here and a living room here and a bathroom here and a kitchen here and so on, right? They didn't just, you know, keep building and adding things on. At least they shouldn't have, okay? But they had a plan. And music is composed usually with a plan like that. And in the tune Ain't She Sweet, let me play the first, the main section. And then it repeats again. Okay, so let's see how many measures that. That was. I'll count up. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 4. 3, 2, 4. 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7. 8. And then it goes to a different section. Okay, so the theme is 8 bars long, or 8 measures long. And that's what we call it. Section A. A is the theme, and that was the theme of Ain't She Sweet, what we just played, okay? And that's repeated. After you play it once, you play it another time, okay? So we have A, A, and then there's a contrasting section in the middle called section B. And it goes like this. Back to A. Okay, so that was 8 bars long too. So we have 4 sections, 4 rooms to our house. A, which is 8 bars long, A, which is 8 bars long, B, which is 8 bars long, and A, which is 8 bars long. Okay, so we have 8, 8, 8, and 8. We have a 32 bar song. Now, why do we want to know that? Well, for one thing, if you learn section A, how much of the song have you learned? Have you learned 1/4 of the song? No, you've learned 3/4 of the song, haven't you? All you need to do is learn that middle part. So that's a key to learning music faster. Almost always there are themes and variations in pieces, no matter what the form is. And if you can figure out the form and what repeats where, you can save yourself a lot of time learning it, okay? So that's the form of Ain't She Sweet. Now, tomorrow we'll take up swing bass. There's a lot of elements that go into that kind of playing, but we're going to take up this. Okay, and so on, okay? Then the middle section will be a little different. That sort of thing, okay? That'll contrast with the first part. So we not only have rooms that contrast, A, A, B, A, but we have styles that contrast as well. So next time we'll take up the swing bass, which is where it's called swing bass because you swing between a low note and a chord. Okay, and we'll take that up tomorrow. So please join me again tomorrow as we continue our series on Ain't She Sweet. And if you haven't already signed up for our whole series of free piano tips, go over to playpiano.com and do that. Thanks. Bye-bye for now.